Everybody, I'm Kirsty Mickey, and welcome back to the Halloween edition of the Kirsty Mickey Now and Ale Show. Sorry. So, this video is going to be inspired by Beetlejuice. Because I love Beetlejuice, and when I think of Halloween, I immediately think of Beetlejuice. I don't know about you, Adam. What do you think of?
Sweet.
Oh, yeah, trick-or-treating.
Lots and lots of sweets.
There is that. But we're going to do a Beetlejuice-inspired nail. And I might even do two. We'll see. We'll see. Time is, you know, is important, so we might not have enough time, but if we do, I will do too. So we're going to start with the most famous thing, I think, with Beetlejuice that people think about is black and white stripes. I am obsessed with black and white stripes. I love black and white stripes. I think they look amazing in interior design. They look amazing on clothes, you know, and obviously they look amazing on Beetlejuice. So we're going to do black and white stripes, but we're also going to add a little bit of something else as well. Okay, so keep watching. The white and the black, so you've got Snow White and Sirius Black, are two very pigmented colours. However, if I try to put white over the top of black, you may see a little bit of the black. If we do it the other way around, if we put the black over the white, I know that the black will cover the white. So we're going to start with... So if you're thinking about doing stripes, you haven't got to do a white stripe, a black stripe, a white stripe, a black stripe. You're going to lay down the background colour first, and that will be the colour for your other stripes. So I have seen people do it before, and they've done individual stripes, and it's like, it takes a lot of effort, that does. So we're going to take the effort out of it, and you'll only actually do black stripes, but on a white background, and it'll just go black and white, black and white, black and white, black and white. Yep, you get me? So we're going to do this white background colour. So we're going to do two coats of this colour. We want it to be super opaque. I'm using a clear nail, so you've got to think about, you know, if you've got a clear nail, somebody's come in, they want to change a design, and they've got a clear acrylic nail on, or a clear gel nail on, then you've got to think about, if it's clear, it definitely needs, you know, a good two coats of colour. If it was a nude nail, or even a natural, like the natural acrylic powder that we've got, then... You know, it covers very easily, that does. So just bear that in mind. With two coats will be perfect. So second coat of colour. You do want to do nice thin layers. Don't be tempted to just whack on like one big thick layer. If you do that, then your client may experience some peeling of your gel polish. You can see that I let the brush kind of run down the edges of the nail, which is going to cap the nail. Kind of like shrink wraps around the full nail then. What I'm going to do now is wipe off the sticky layer that the gel polish has. So it has a sticky layer and it'll go slightly matte. More like, not completely matte, it'll go like a satin finish. And what we're going to do then is we're going to get the black. I'm going to pop it onto a palette. It's much easier to do this if it's on a palette rather than working directly from the bottle. If you work directly from the bottle, any sunlight or any UV light that may be in your fake lights, that's not what I meant, in your artificial lighting, you know, that might cure the polish. We don't want that. So we're putting it on a palette. So I have here, this is a liner brush and it's 03. And it's one of the longest liner brushes that Nao Nails do. Because I've got another one here just to show you it's shorter. It's treble 03. And you can see the difference. It's quite a big difference between the two. And the reason I'm using this one is because we're going to do such long lines and it's a little bit thicker. So you can see that I'm making sure that the gel is going through all of the bristles of the brush just by running that through. And what you can do is you could have a little test on your palette. So as you pull like that, and we bend just over half of the brush. Now if we only bend a little bit of the brush, you see the difference? You get a finer line, but we want quite chunky lines.
I think that would have been ASMR for quite a few people just watching that happen.
Line.
People always comment on the channel saying, oh my God, I can't believe how you can do a straight line that straight.
My God. Right, so I'm going to make sure I'm steady. I'm moving everything out of the way there. I'm going to place the brush down. And then I'm going to bend and pull. And I'm going to go over this a few times. I'm just getting a little bit more product on my brush. So we have a nice line. I just want to make sure this is wide enough at the top. And what I'm going to do is cure each one. So you can see how that black is super opaque because it's so pigmented and it really does cover the white. And then I'm going to come next to that. And again, press and bring that down the nail. And I'm going to cure that. Same again, give it a cure. So you could be working on the other nail on another hand in between so you can keep curing and save your time later.
What recommendations would you give for people who don't have like sort of a steady hand like you do?
The thing is, it's not necessarily my steady hand. It's the fact that the brush is so long that the brush kind of does all the work for you. And if you don't like it, just get a little bit of gel residue light wipe off solution on your brush and then just knitting it up. But I'm going to go straight back into this again. It's the brush that's keeping it steady more than anything else, to be honest. So if I show you now, sort of on here, it is important to hold the finger really steady. And if your client is sat there on their phone, you will not have straight lines. They think they're not moving, but they really are. Because that little bit of movement will actually make the hand move.
Naming no names, Faye.
Exactly. Exactly. So, if I pull down on this and I go a little bit shaky, can you see it's still quite straight? So I'm wobbling the brush and it's still straight. Does that make sense? The shorter the brush, the less room for error. So when you're doing portrait work, art-wise, you can use a short brush because you need it so precise on, you know, little like details. But for something like this, you need it long. The longer, the better. You want to watch the gel touching the nail as well, because you might look at it and there might be, maybe you've overloaded your brush. Maybe there's not enough gel on the brush. That will make a difference as well. That's why you want like an even distribution of product throughout the length of your brush like that. You don't want to like have it like that, where you've got like a big ball of product on the end. That's why I pull it through the palette like this. So it has a very even amount of product throughout the length of the brush. Right, I'm just going to use pitch purple on this other nail to see if we've got enough time just to do something else that could go with this design. So I'm going to do two coats of this colour. Right, so what we're going to do now is I'm going to apply the Urban Graffiti top coat. So this is the shiny top coat. Just going to give it a nice glossy shine. But we're not finished yet. And then I'm going to use, can you find me the name for this one, Adam? It's 0094.
Purple Rain.
Purple Rain, Purple Rain. With a bit of a
different kind of rain. It's R-E-I-G-N, so like as in reigning like a queen. Or a prince, I suppose.
Ah, see what they did there. Right, and I put pitch purple on the top. I'm going to create a little bit of a blend. I'm going to use the ombre brush. We're going to go into the paler purple first. Then we're going to tap, tap, tap and start to bring that down. Just to create that ombre. Let's put that in the lamp. Right, so we're going back to our stripy nail. Then I've got two colours here. We've got tangy lime and we've got sour lemon. So what I love about Beetlejuice is the green. Oh my God, that green is amazing. And what I'm going to create is, instead of like slime kind of drips, I'm going to do flames. So I'm just going to mark my flames out first of all, using these sort of like curved shapes, and you kind of connect those together. I want to do one slightly higher than the other at the bottom. Oh, my voice. So we started with three curves, and then now I've got that laid down, what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill that shape in with this green. And we'll do two coats of that colour, just to get it a little bit more opaque. So, second coat of the tangy lime colour. So if we go back to this little ombre, what we've done, what I'm going to do this time on this one is, where's the white? We need white. I'm going to start with some white here. I'm going to put some on my palette. I'm going to do some flame shapes. Thank you. I'm going to do two coats of white on that so we get really good opaque colour. Now with this one, back to, oh, I love this. Going to get this sour lemon now.
Oh, I could just have a lemon sour. Talking about sweets again.
I've just popped a bit on the back here. And what I'm going to do is, what it'll do is it kind of brightens up the yellow, the green, sorry. I'm just going to blend that up a bit. And then we're going to use it to kind of highlight little parts of the flames. And it'll really intensify the colour. I'm just adding a little bit of that tangy lime just so we get like a couple of different tones of the green. I'll pop that in the lamp. I love it. Right, what we're going to do with this is we're going to use the matte top coat now.
Well, I knew it'd be there somewhere.
I can't leave it out, can I? And I'm just going to matte top coat the flames. So I'm going to put some product down. And then I'll use a smaller brush. So with the smaller brush, then you can sort of trace that shape. It's a lot easier than you think. Because it's already there. It's a lot easier to just go directly over the top of the shape that you've done of the flames. So this is like Beetlejuice inspired, but it's still got a modern twist to it because they are flames, and you know, flames are really fashionable at the minute. They really are a vibe. So this vibe will continue, I think, for quite some time. Everybody's still loving flames. Right, I'll pop that in the lamp. And what it'll do, it'll create like a 3D effect as well, because it'll give it some high. Now, back to our little purple ombre with the white. Now, it's going to get interesting now. Because what we're going to do is we're going to use the black. And I'm going to make these flames stripy. Like, how cool is that? So like we did before, it's really important to lay down that white first. So we do the open area first. By the open area, I mean, you know, not those sort of peaks of the flames. So we're going to do the easiest area first. And that'll give you your guide for where your next lines are going to go. Because we're going to follow them through into the flames. I'm going to cure those first. Oh, look. Oh, look, look, look. I love it. How cool does that look? I like the different tones of green in the flames. And when you actually put it in the lamp, the sour lemon actually glows. It looks really cool. And I think it's different because the flames are coming from the cuticle area as well. So I think that looks kind of cool, don't you? I love it. Right, so now that's cured, we can concentrate on the flames and following through the lines into these tails of the flames. Now I'm definitely going to use a shorter brush now, because I need more precision. You know, we were talking about earlier about when it's shorter, you can get a lot more precision. So a shorter brush, then we can do our little lines going into those tails of the flames. Cure that. Just want to add a little bit more white here, just so it exaggerates the flame being that black and white stripe. And then with this one, it's all going to be matte.
The whole thing?
The whole thing. But I want you to, if you do a design like this, you can then make the choice. You can do it like we did it just, where you've got some matte and some shiny. Or you could do it all shiny or all matte. At least doing it this way for you, you get a good look at how it looks, and hopefully you can make your own choice on what you prefer. I think the flames need to be shiny. You know.
Which one? On the sill? On the
this one?
Thingy one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought that's what you were going to do. Because the other one, they're shiny, aren't they?
No, they're matte on the other one.
Black. Oh, are they? I can't really see.
Yeah, they're matte on this one.
Oh, well,
one.
If they're matte.
Why do you think they need to be shiny?
No, if they're matte on that one, then I don't think they need to be matte on the other.
No, I think they need to be shiny. I think the black and white looks better shiny.
So you're going to make the black, the white. All right, okay.
I'm going to make the black and white stripes on both nails shiny. I do, I just think it. I didn't like it so much. So I thought, well, I'm going to change that. We are all good in the hood. Yeah, I prefer it shiny. I prefer the flames on this one shiny, but the flames on that one matte. I think they look good together because the black and white stripes are both shiny. Do you know what I mean? And it just gives you like lots of different options of how you can do it. I do love the flames being stripy. I do think that's pretty cool. So there you are, guys. Let me just have a little zoom in.
Did it say that purple and green should never be seen, or whatever, what is that?
Isn't that red and green?
I don't know.
Bit of Beetlejuice inspired nail art for you there. So there you are, guys. I hope you have a great Halloween. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything I've used today will be listed below. Go check it out and keep watching. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
See you later.
Alicia, turn that down. Can you hear it?
Okay.
And bring me halloumi.